Let me tell you something. Put your trust in a man that went all the way to Calvary for you. Put your trust in somebody tonight that can take you all the way to glory land. Mankind will let you down. Mankind will use you, abuse you, and kick you off to the side. And Jesus will be right there to pick you back up every time you fall in a mud hole. Don't keep playing there. Jesus will pick you back up. He'll clean you back off, and he'll put you right back out there on the road of recovery. Let me tell you something. We got too many people not wanting no recovery anymore. They just want all the blessings without doing anything for them. You know, when we go to work, that guy you work for or that woman you work for expects you to work while you're there if you want a paycheck at the end of the week. You know, I tell them all the time, working for the Lord down here don't pay much, but the reward's out of this world. You know, I'm glad I didn't get in for the money. Praise be to God. I got in it because I want to see one more soul say, I got a void in my life and I need Jesus come into my heart. I need Jesus more than I do this world, because this world is getting ready to pass away. This world's getting ready to burn down. This world, the Bible said, even the elements in it's going to melt like fervent heat. I'm telling you what, time is swiftly passing by. This is November of 2012. If we went by man's prediction, we just got one more month to live down here anyway. We've done got people saying December the 21st, 2012 is judgment day. I guarantee you one thing, it'll be judgment day for somebody, because when you leave this world, you're gone. And I'm persuaded that you're going to stand before Jesus and you're going to stand in judgment. And he said you're going to give an account for what you did in this body, whether it be good or bad. So I'm persuaded, he's right in a sense and he's wrong in a sense, because December the 21st, 2012, there'll be people leave this earth because they died. Time is swiftly passing away, and we've got family and loved ones that die and lost because they got a void in their life. They got a void in their life, and they're trying it with everything. They're trying it with drugs. They're trying it with alcohol. They're trying it, with everything out there in the world, and yet they're going home, and they're still misery, and they're still just laying down in the night saying, what am I going to do? I can't do this on my own. You know, you can't do it on your own. I can't do it on my own. I can't even walk without the Lord holding my hand. I can't even talk without him giving me the words to say. I can't even breathe without him giving me the oxygen in these lungs. You know what? We need to thank him each and every day for the blessings he bestows on us. If you woke up this morning in your right mind, you ought to praise Jesus for that. If you got up this morning and you can still see your spouse, your kids, you ought to praise the Lord for that. Because let me tell you something, one of these days you're going to wake up and that spouse ain't going to be there no more. One of these days you're going to wake up and them children ain't going to be there no more. One of these days Jesus is going to step out on that eastern sky, and all of us has been born again, we're going to leave this old earth. We're going to leave and we're going to have a flight without a airplane. But I'm telling you what, time is something this world ain't got a whole lot more of, because it's getting ready to come to an end. Because everything that has happened, everything that's happening around us, and I ain't no politician, I ain't going to talk about politics, but God knowed from the beginning what's going to happen in 2012. Listen, I tell them all the time down Morgan Branch, if you want a better pastor, pray for the one you got, amen? And then I told them, if you want a better president, pray for the one we got. Listen, the Bible tells us and commands us to pray for them that's in authority. I say, Christians around the world, if they'd get down on their hands and knees, if they would call out to Almighty God to send the conviction power down all them that's in Washington, from Washington all the way down to Kentucky, I'd say, their minds and their hearts would be changed, and our nation would get back on the right track. And let me tell you something, if our nation got back on the right track, I believe God would start blessing the United States again. Listen, I can't stand to see them little signs on the back here, because it said, God bless America. He ain't going to bless America that's killing them unborn babies each and every day. He's not going to bless America that says it's okay for a man to marry a man and a woman to marry a woman. He's not going to bless America, because he destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. Listen, for a lot less than that. So we need to be about the Father's business. People out there tonight's got voids in their life, and the only thing that can fill that void is Jesus Christ.